Welcome to the virtual vernissage of the exhibition here in the main hall of the Faculty of Humanities. If you come here to see all these pictures with your own eyes, and not just on the Facebook site of the International Autumn of the University, what may struck you immediately is how intensely these pictures could change the atmosphere of this whole space. And this effect is not brought by chance, but due to the very colorful, very vivid character, very vivid Latino, I would say, character of these pictures. But if the artists exhibiting here would hear me calling them Latino, I am sure they would protest, because they emphatically identify themselves as Chicanos. Chicano, the term you probably know, refers to Mexican Americans born in the United States. The name, if you come here and want to see who are the exhibiting artists, you will find the name Los Supersonicos. And this name covers a duo, two high-profile artists, Carlos Fresquez and Frank Zamora. They come from Denver, United States, and from Mexico. They began under this name working together in 1998. Fresquez in the United States, in Denver, and Zamora in Mexico. So they have been exploring the Chicano identity together in collaboration for more than two decades now. Fresquez was born in Denver, the city which is considered to be the source for the anti-racist movement and civil rights movement and activism in the 60s and early 70s, which spread nationwide in the United States. And Zamora was born in Colorado, was raised in Mexico, and now lives part of the year in the United States and part of the year in Mexico City. So they come from different understandings of the Chicano identity and culture, and the Chicano movement itself and its heritage, but they both look at and examine the multi-layered underpinning of this Chicano identity. This multi-layeredness of their work and their thinking is not only metaphorical in their case, but it is very clearly reflected in their working method as well. Because as they work in a team, they exchange work in progress, they alter and sometimes even deface each other's work until they reach a state where they both can accept the version as the final composition. So this multi-layered identity of their pictures refers not only their visual heritage, not only their meaning, but also it is literally, or we could say materially, true in their case. The name of Los Supersonicos, I think, is very telling in two ways. Los Supersonicos is the Latin American name of the very famous animated American sitcom series, The Jetsons. So as the choice of the name suggests, their visual language uses very heavily, or builds very heavily on the popular imagery. They use characters from cartoons, comic books, you can see here. And so popular culture and popular imagery is here with lots of humor and very colorfully. And also it reflects the global visual culture of the 21st century. I could call it a certain neo-pop art. And on the other hand, as the sitcom The Jetsons was a series of the space-time, perhaps we can guess that the name also refers to the future. So these pictures are presented as trips with very strong sense of movement, trips to the future, a future that is, of course, imaginative, very colorful, and as I said, with lots of humor, these pictures, these imaginative future pictures, blend a unique type of Mexican-American culture that still flourishes in the southwest of America, the overall American culture, and of course, the global culture. What is very special, I think, about these tech team pictures is that their duality is not only characteristic of their working method, but it's their overall general character. So deeply running roots of visual identity and the visual language of the contemporary urban life. This strong duality can at the same time both mock and also pay homage to the traditional Chicano culture and art, and in the form of traditional icons like the Aztec icons of the calendar, snakes, skulls, eagles, and you will see what others. So on the one hand, these pictures embrace the iconographic, thematic, and narrative heritage of classic Chicano art. And on the other hand, they also absorb and process other non-Chicano sources like contemporary international art. You can detect some resonances of Robert Rauschenberg, Jim Dine, or Keith Haring, for instance, or even you can say that even early European modernism can be found here. What we can definitely see in these pictures is the influence of Chicano muralism, a kind of strong factor in the movement of the Chicano anti-racist movements that started in Denver. And also you can trace here the influence of the graffiti art of the 80s and 90s. So back in the early 70s, Chicano muralism was a very important catalyst for the community engagement and community activism. And also the graffiti art of the 80s was also to tag landmarks, just to prove to the world that they exist. So we cannot avoid, I think, saying that though in a visually very popular and colorful way, but these pictures still protest. they tell us a very timely story. They evoke the political fights of the 60s, the heroes, the emblems, the slogans of that time that strived to reach some positive changes in racism. And now Los Supersonicos rewrite these heroes, these emblems, the slogans of the time. And now what they suggest with this superimposing of imagery is that perhaps we can live without cultural frontiers, that these frontiers that divide us can be or must be again and again renegotiated. Especially now that the US administration is building a new wall on the Mexican-American border, it is time to ponder the question of borders again, especially that this duo also raises this question in their joint artist statement. As they say, who crossed the border first when there was no border? Or with other words, I could say that they didn't cross the border, but the border crossed them. So the Los Supersonicos, as they say, they zoom into the future, and what they see is a vision, a future without cultural frontiers, because the cultures we can see here can be presented in a very colorful, in a very vivid and unified composition. So, in a sense, these pictures of Los Supersonicos still protest. And for us, Europeans, it may be, or it should be, a reminder to think over how far we have come since the Berlin Wall. Thank you.